My heart is a little heavy right now. Like, oh my gosh. Do I want to cry? I don't want to cry. I just feel disappointed. I feel let down. No, let's just be transparent. I am a supporter of Sister. I love Tia and Tamara. I like Tamara more than I like Tia because of their show. Tia was kind of mean to Tamara. And so I always kind of, my heart goes out to the underdog, whatever. Not saying that Tamara is the underdog, but I feel like she was being mistreated a little bit by her sister. Like, you know, the jokes, you know, anyway. And I just got off of work, had a busy day. And I'm going through my phone looking at the blogs. And I see Tia with her husband. And the lines going through it, like, breaking up. And I'm like, what? And I read the caption, and they are getting a divorce. Tia. And I like Tia because Tia do remind me a lot of myself. Tamara more so, though. But Tia and Tamara both, they have morals, values, good people, from what it seems. You know, I don't know them personally. And to see that, I'm like, wow. Oh. Word on the curb is that before Tia announced that she's getting a divorce or whatever, she and her husband did post something in their stories. This is what Tia posted. And this is what Corey posted, her husband. What do that mean? They talking in circles, riddles. But she said something about letting go might hurt, but it beats living in illusion. And that spoke volumes. Living in illusion. An illusion is when something appears one way, but it's not. And so that tells me she might feel as though on the outside looking in, things look good, in which it did. But inside the home, there's lots of issues. Now, let's go back. Remember a few years ago when Kiki Palmer and Corey was in a movie together? And word on the street was that Kiki, oh, she made a comment. She said that Corey is handsome or would be a good husband. Something. She said something about Corey.
Tell us about your characters working together, working with Macy Gray, to create a family on screen for Brotherly Love.
Well, I mean, I've been a fan of Corey since I was a kid. He auditioned for Kiela and the V, and I was like, I'm gonna marry this man. So, I've known Corey for a really long time, and then Erica.
And I remember Tia had posted a little statement saying this. And nobody said nothing else about it. But that spoke volumes to me. Like, what made her feel the need to go out and address her like that publicly? That was a red flag to me. Like, what's going on? And also, I like Tia and Tamara. You can't tell me that they did not fall out. They had not seen each other or post pics or mentioned each other for a while until a year after COVID. They had become distant. So I think it's not about them. It's about Tia. Tia, my girl, my heart goes out to you. I liked what they stood for. She was with him when he didn't really have much. And now he's this established actor doing his thing. They just had a baby, like, what, 4 or 5 years ago, if I'm not mistaken? Maybe 6, I don't know. They've been building their family. What happened? They was on that love, black love show. But recently, someone did post about how he was talking and Tia interrupted him. I can't post it here, but maybe I'll post it down below. I don't know. But that was like, but it wasn't rude, though. It's like, you know, folks just talking and you like over talking me. Hold on, I'll stop. But he wasn't rude from what I saw. What do you think? I think that this is a reminder for me to just not look at other relationships. I don't know, because I am inspired by friends who are married. I am inspired by celebrities who are married and have what I think is good relationships. It shows me that there can be another way to date other than what we call the hookup culture. And so even like Sierra and Wilson, someone had posted like, okay, who next? or that Sierra is next. Russell bet not. But folks get divorces. I'm older now. I'm in my 30s. So I definitely understand that relationships change. And that's okay. But that's why, too, it's important to hook up with someone not that you think you can love for today, but also tomorrow. The hookup culture, that's not good, because you can create babies with someone that you can't stand. But she did post a lovely post saying, "Hey, you guys, I've always been honest with my fans, and I wanted to let y'all know that me and Corey have decided to go our separate ways, but we will always be friends and co-parent, and we're looking forward to our future journey," or whatever. Tia. Now, Corey is fine. See, now, let's say, like, Corey is the type of guy, physical-wise, that I go for. I've had guys that look like him. What happened? I gotta know. Something gonna come out. Something is gonna come out. And when it does, I'm gonna be like, because if you love some, I mean, but I don't think he was cheating, but was he? Could that have been it? Because, you know, folks traveling, folks not always together, you get on the road and you have a little tickle, a little itch. Beautiful home, cute kids, in California, moving and shaking. What happened? Tia Mowry, Corey Hardict, are filing for a divorce, getting a divorce. It's just, my brain is trying to process this. I'm recording a video. Playing that ratchet music beside me. Oh, but here's the thing, right? Folks, when you have kids, sometimes folks get married, you know, and then they divorce when their kids are like in their 30s or in their 40s. I think they were married for a purpose. That was to raise their kids. They did that. And now they say, you know what? I want something else. Sierra parents was married. I remember her stating that. And they divorced. Beyonce parents divorced after they raised their kids. Tia Mowry and Tamara, their parents also divorced. So it happens. You know, I have friends who have divorced. It happens. But this is something to look into. I feel like marriage is just people. Are you willing to stay with someone truly through thick and thin? Are you really able to marry someone and not cheat? Was counseling involved? Like, did they seek counseling? Like, I never thought I would see Tia with another man on the red carpet kissing and cheesing. Or Corey with another chick. But that's life. Things happen. We're grown. Feelings change. You grow out of love. And I'm just really praying for the family. And I hope you are too. But this is just, you never know what folks are going through. You never know what's going on behind those closed doors. Trust me, I know. You just never know. But I think he did something. Oh, it could have been Tia. Tia might be hard to love. Tia might have been cheated on. He had to set some things straight. Trust issues. What happened? Who did what, why, when, where, and with who? What y'all think about this? Bye.